So this is the tallest new dam built in the United States in the past 25 years. In August, we passed 241 feet tall, which makes Chimney Hollow Dam one of the tallest dams along the Front Range, taller than any dam we have at Horsetooth or Carter Lake.
The design of the Chimney Hollow Dam is only one of two in the U.S. right now that has an asphalt core and rock fill shell. So there's over 200 of these worldwide, but these are the first two in North America, and Chimney Hollow is by far the largest. So what the asphalt core does, it provides an impermeable barrier to the water, but it's not very strong. So we have the impermeable barrier, which is the asphaltic core, and then we have these rock fill shells, which support the core, keep it vertical, and provide the strength that it needs to hold back the water. So the project started about 3 years ago. It started by clearing the foundation of all the overburden materials to get down to rock to found the dam on rock. Then we installed a grout curtain below the core of the dam to increase the seepage length and decrease the amount of seepage. And then from then, we started building up the embankment.
Currently, the main dam is about 280 feet tall, leaving about 70 feet left till the top.
The ultimate safety of the dam is really based on the quality that we build it to. And we take quality is of the utmost importance on the project. We have over 40 inspectors and engineers that are focused on quality. Our two materials testing labs take over 400 tests a week to measure and compare it to the quality metrics that we have for the project to ultimately ensure that the dam is safe when we first put water in it and for 100 years to come.
So all of the aggregate material we use on site, including for the main dam, the asphalt, and the concrete, we produce on site. We produce about 62,000 tons of material a day, making this one of the largest quarry in the state of Colorado. Most of the material from the quarry is hauled directly onto the dam, and what doesn't get hauled onto the dam gets sent to our aggregate processing facility.
This is the quarry that we have on site. All the drop till it is what's used in main dam, saddle dam, the roads, and the crushing facilities. So far, we've shot about 12.5 million yards. Coming up through the end of the year, we'll have about 2 more million yards to shoot. The quarry will be completed.
Right now, for zone 4, we're trying to do 30,000 yards a day or 15,000 a shift. Weber, our crushing subcontractor, does anywhere from 2,500 to 5,000 cubic yards a day.
Usually we blast 6 days a week on site, one time per day. Coming into the winter, we'll be slowing down to 4 or 5 days a week.
In the next few months, we are trying to knock out most of our wash material before the winter months, before it gets cold. Most of that wash material can't be produced in the colder months in the winter time. But here shortly, there's going to be a lot of Zone 3 being produced. Right now, we're looking at March or April for all crushing production to be over. Their demand schedule is kind of just based off of our demand schedule on the main dam.
I work alongside Wallow, our subcontractor from Europe that does the paving for the asphalt port. So I make sure they have everything they need to place asphalt every day, as well as everything the crew that supports them needs to keep them running, keep their pavement loaded, and place a lift of asphalt every day. Should be done with asphalt, and the main dam should be topped out in about, you know, spring, March-ish of 2025.
As we head into the fall and winter, we're going to see a few things start wrapping up on site. The main dam will also start getting a little narrower on top, which makes it a little more congested for the trucks moving around. We are feeling good about our placement and schedule as we are heading to the fall and winter.